Red Wings Live is brought to you by Ram Trucks. Come in and get a great deal on the best trucks during Ram Truck Month. And by Menards. Save big money at Menards on all your home improvement needs. The Maple Leafs held the Wings to just one goal in each of their last four meetings. They were trying to do that in five straight games for the first time since the 1938-39 season. The Wings were having none of that. They erased that possibility with four goals in the first 25 minutes, making for what turned out to be a jolly good show at the Joe. For more on Game 1 of 82, here's Ken Daniels and Mickey Redmond with an opening night booth report, guys.
Well, for all the talk about competitive balance in the National Hockey League, there are some who cannot compete with the depth that the Detroit Red Wings have and how they showed tonight.
Well, their second tier, if you want to call it that, came through, and that was Abdelkader with a hat trick tonight. You pointed out he had 23 last year, far and above his numbers from before, but I mean, he's just really taken the bull by the horns, playing with mostly Zetterberg and Datsyuk. Tonight it was Zetterberg and Larkin, and they were the number one line without question, and Abdelkader bangs in three goals. Oh, what a great start for him. But one of the things that he's really improved upon, Ken, I think, is his ability to finish. We saw a lot of times last year he got open up the middle, he took long bomb passes, and bang, he was beating goaltenders to the blocker side. And tonight, you know, his first goal was alertly done off the goalpost on a Frangin shot on a power play early in the game. Second one set up there again, blocker side for Justin Abdelkader on a bullet wrist shot. And then the two-on-one with Larkin. And this one, first goal against Reimer after the change. That made it 4-0 there. And, boy, what a way to start the season out for number eight from Muskegon. They can really use this. When you got Abdelkader with Tatar and Nyquist, which would be your middle scoring, so to speak, age-wise, to go with your veterans and to go with people like Larkin on the back end as the kids, pretty good stuff.
Boy, you know, from a veteran team, this is such a young Red Ring group, and
I love it.
Great way to start the season.
All right, guys, thank you. Here's a look at the upcoming game schedule brought to you by your Detroit area Honda dealers. The Wings will be back in action tomorrow night in Carolina before coming back to the Joe to take on the Lightning and the Hurricanes. And then they'll take on the Canadiens in Montreal next Saturday. All right, up next, we'll take you back through all the opening night festivities, and we'll hear what Mike Babcock thought of his return to Hockey Town. He probably didn't like it too much. That and more when Red Wings Live. Got their season started on the right foot tonight and made Mike Babcock's return to the Joe an unsuccessful one as they blow out the Maple Leafs 4-0. Justin Abdelkader completing the hat trick in the second period, the second of his career. It was a good night down there at the Joe from the sellout crowd. Great start, obviously, for the Wings this season. Darren, Ozzie, and Mick back with you here on Red Wings Live. And it wasn't such a great start, of course, for the Red Wings. They're now, are the Leafs, they're now 0-2, and it certainly appears Mike Babcock has his work cut out for him there in Toronto, Ozzie.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the first thing Mike Babcock's trying to do is get some structure into this team. First, they just don't have enough talent to compete at an NHL level right now. They need that structure defensively. They gave up less shots, but they gave up some humdinger chances tonight. Really, this is what the Leafs are. We were just talking earlier. They might have had their best game against Montreal, and they still lost that game. So it looks to be a long, long season in Toronto.
Yeah, you can have structure, and you can minimize your you know, mistakes, and you can really just try to keep the puck out of your net. They can't score. And really, in many areas of the ice, Mike Babcock's going to break that game down and say, we didn't compete hard enough. We weren't in the right position defensively. And if you're trying to limit your mistakes and your exposure defensively, you're going to have to pay attention to those details. They don't even have a team identity yet as an organization. They will get that with him and Lou Lamoriello and Jacques Lemaire. They don't have it right now. They're working through it. You can see the players on the ice to me were like, okay, I'm thinking while I'm playing. That makes you slow, no matter what game you're in.
They've scored only 8 goals, that's including exhibition. So they're really having some troubles finding that net right now. And like I said, they look like they're afraid to make mistakes out there. They're just not playing with any type of flow whatsoever. So, I mean, it's only 2 out of 82. They have 80 to go, but it just appears it's going to be a long, long year.
Toronto, not that far from Detroit, but in many ways, it's light years away. In 10 seasons in Detroit, Babcock became the winningest coach in franchise history. But his return to the Joe no doubt left something to be desired. Here's what he had to say about it a moment ago.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, You know, they scored on the power play. They scored another goal right away. You know, we had three guys home three. We never got anything, and they just scored on their chances. And like you say, hard hill to climb. But I thought they were more competitive in front of both nets than we were tonight. I didn't think we gave up a ton, but when we did, they were stronger on their sticks in front of our net than we were in front of their net and on the walls.
Some of your guys have talked about responding better to adversity. Is that kind of an issue from the other night as well that you felt tonight?
Well, I don't know about that. I mean, adversity to me is what you went through tonight, and are going to respond tomorrow. There's nothing we can do about tonight here and now. We got down two. We go in the period and we give up a goal on the first shift of the second period. Obviously, that really sank us. So anyway, you look at it, two is, obviously a way better situation than we were after one shift in the second period, 4-on-4, where they shot it under the bar. So, the bottom line is we got to keep it out better.
Mike, obviously not the script you envisioned when you came back to Detroit. Can you just kind of reflect on your first game back after 10 years?
Well, I mean, the bottom line is they won the game. You came here for 2 points, and we didn't get that. So, I mean, that part's disappointing. I was surprised at how good Detroit played or anything like that. I just think we got to be better.
What did you think of the ovation you got?
Yeah, it was nice of them to do. They sure didn't have to do that, obviously. I don't coach the team anymore. I've said it a number of times. I'm glad this is all over with, to be honest with you. At least played the Red Wings today, and they won. It's that simple. So I appreciate that, but, move on here. And obviously, we got a game tomorrow here. We got to get regrouped because we got to play better than that.
Thoughts on Larkin? Is that another rookie people should be talking about?
Well, I sure think so. I asked our guys after, if you compare him and Nylander, because we sent our kids down. Larks tonight obviously played with two real good players, and Zetterberg, a real good leader, and Abdicator, a real physical guy and a real good net presence. And so, those are nice guys to play with if you're a kid. But he obviously gives them speed, and then he competes on every shift. He's real competitive.
Are you trying to find a spark in taking Bernier out there in the second?
Well, I just thought we were down 3-0. Let's put Rhymes in. He's playing tomorrow. Give him a chance to get going.
I guess one guy's going to be happy to get out of Detroit for the time being. Here's the breakaway rewards play brought to you by Total Hockey. And usually when someone gets a hat trick like Justin Abdicator tonight, they will get this. But your first NHL goal will trump that. And Dylan Larkin's second period goal gave the Wings a 3-0 lead. The 19-year-old's goal helps propel the Wings to the 4-0 win over the Leafs. All right, still more on the way from the Joe. Justin Abdicator got a jump on the trick-or-treating tonight. The highlights from his trick in tonight's instant replay. Hey. As for the Wings, they had a lot of things going for them even before they stepped on the ice tonight. The emotion of opening night, the original six opponent, and the desire to beat the head coach that stood behind their bench for 10 seasons. It turned into what a lot of us may end up doing this weekend, a burning of the Leafs. You can feel the heat in tonight's instant replay.
Ladies and gentlemen, training camp is complete. The preseason is complete. And all that's left to do is meet your 2015-16 Detroit Red Wings.
To Zetterberg, Jakob Kindle in the first unit on the back end with Nick Cronwall. Cronson with a shot. Turns with it, makes a nice move, gets a shot to the goal as Abdicator was pulled into by Harrington into Bernier. Came to him again, Abdicator scores! What a hard working goal!
Set up by guess who? Dylan Larkin's first point as a Red Wing.
I think my whole life I've been dreaming about this, and I think going through camp has got me pretty ready for this.
Brings it in, scores! Oh, his first NHL goal is a beauty!
Wow, look at him getting the puck. Cronwall getting the puck for a fish right under the net.
Pass knocked away by Quincy. Ooh. Here's a break for Abdicator. Two goals tonight. Up with Larkin. Abdicator scores! Hat trick! Justin Abdicator!
I'm going to get your curly fries. Oh, what a snapshot by Justin Abdelkader on the turnover. 2-on-1, the hats are flying. And Jeff Flasho has his first National Hockey League victory. The start to the Jeff Flasho era is one with an exclamation point on this night for sure.
4 for the Wings, 0 for the Leafs. Jimmy Howard posts his 21st career shutout. Henrik Zetterberg turned 35 today. He celebrates with a three-point night. Justin Abdelkader's hat trick, of course, made for a good post-game conversation with Trevor Thompson.
Huge night for Justin Abdelkader and the Red Wings on opening night here in Detroit. Hat trick on opening night. You get the first goal of the season. You guys get a shutout. Blasho gets his first win. So many things to cover here, Justin. What jumps out to you first?
Dylan Larkin's first goal, for sure. He played such a good game tonight. You know, a big part of, you know, all the goals out there for us. You know, he's going to have a really bright future, and it's great to see, you know, from the organization's point. And from our point, we're excited. 19-year-old, and I think that was a big storyline coming in, and he lived up to it.
Big storyline coming in, too, is your new head coach, Jeff Blasho, going up against your old head coach, Mike Babcock. How good does it feel to get Blasho win in game number one against the old guy?
Yeah, it feels good. I think Blash, you know, is a little extra special. But you know what? Now that we get by this game, it's we got to turn the page, and now it's just gonna be Babs over there. It's what we got to get used to. So we're excited. You know, we played well for most of the portions of the game, but still got things to work on. Kind of got on our heels there a little bit, you know, at the end of periods there. But you know, great overall win for us, and you know, excited. We're excited to start the, you know, season with a win.
And Jimmy Howard pitches a shutout. Tell me about his night in net.
Yeah, he made some big saves when he had to. You know, Howie, you know, a lot of people doubted Howie, you know, coming into the season, but you know, Howie, a lot of people forget he was an all-star last year, and you know, he's a great goalie. He's a proven goalie in this league, and you know, we have a good problem. We have you know, him and Mrazek, who are both NHL goalies, and you know, Howie, I bet you that felt good for him tonight too, getting that shutout, and you know, that'll be good for his confidence going forward.
I'll bet that.
All right, Habs and the Wings now have Carolina on their mind. The Hurricanes lost their first game of the season. They'll be looking for their first W when they welcome the Wings in for their home opener tomorrow night. We'll have a preview for you next. All right, game number one is in the books. Game number two comes your way tomorrow night when the Wings head to Carolina to take on the Hurricanes right here on Fox Sports Detroit. Red Wings Live. We get the evening started at 6:30. Puck drop comes your way at 7 o'clock. And, guys, Peter Mrazek will be in net for the Wings tomorrow night. On paper, I know it's early, but on paper, it looks like a good opportunity for the Wings to start 2-0.
Yeah, and you want to do that. I mean, so Peter Mrazek, he's going to be hungry to get in there. If I'm watching Carolina, I'm just watching their one young player, Noah Hanifin, on defense.
Yeah, Carolina's one of those teams. They're a quick team. They do have speed. They can be dangerous, but the Red Wings got to go in there, play the exact same way they did tonight. Be a good test for Mrazek coming off the shutout by Jimmy Howard. A little pressure on him moving forward here.
All right, looking forward to it. We'll see you again tomorrow night. Thanks for being with us tonight. Once again, the Wings open up the season with a 4-0 win over the Toronto Maple Leafs. For Darren and Chris and all of us here at Fox Sports Detroit, thanks for watching. Good night, kids.